Thanks be to God.
God be with you.
And also with you.
O God, you made us in your own image and redeemed us through Jesus, your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infect our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love and work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
First reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Watch for the opportune time and beware of evil. And do not be ashamed to be yourself, for there is a shame that leads to sin, and there is a shame that is glory and favor. Do not show partiality to your own harm, or difference to your downfall. Do not refrain from speaking at a proper moment, and do not hide your wisdom, for wisdom becomes known through speech, and education through the word of your tongue. Never speak against the truth, but be ashamed of your ignorance. Do not be ashamed to confess your sins, and do not try to stop the current of a river. Do not subject yourself to a fool or show partiality to a ruler. Fight to the death for truth, and the Lord your God will fight for you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mon âme exalte le Seigneur. Exulte mon esprit en Dieu, mon Sauveur.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
Le puissant fit pour moi des merveilles. Saint est son nom.
He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
Déployant la force de son bras, il disperse les superbes.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly.
Il comble de bien les affamés, renvoie les riches les mains vides.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered the promise of his mercy.
De la promesse faite à nos pères, en faveur d'Abraham et de sa race, à jamais. Gloire au Père et au Fils et au Saint-Esprit, au Dieu qui est, qui était et qui vient, pour les siècles des siècles.
Amen.
Ainsi, la loi a été notre pédagogue pour nous conduire au Christ, afin que nous fussions justifiés par la foi. Mais la foi étant venue, nous ne sommes plus sous un pédagogue. Car vous êtes tous fils de Dieu, par la foi dans le Christ Jésus. Vous tous, en effet, qui avez été baptisés dans le Christ, vous avez revêtu le Christ. Il n'y a plus ni juif, ni grec. Il n'y a plus ni esclave, ni homme libre. Il n'y a plus ni homme, ni femme. Car vous n'êtes tous qu'une personne dans le Christ Jésus. Et si vous êtes au Christ, vous êtes donc descendance d'Abraham, héritier selon la promesse. Entendez ce que l'Esprit dit au peuple de Dieu. Nous rendons grâce à Dieu.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel of John. When he had gone out, Jesus said, Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
With the official Paris Pride March and celebrations in November this year, Pride Month looks very different. In fact, all of 2020 has looked entirely and frighteningly extraordinary. I was in England during lockdown, which meant that my source of news was the BBC. I read the app, and I watched the 10 o'clock news every evening. I wonder if you've heard phrases such as, "Is there any need for pride?" or "There's gay marriage, what else are you fighting for?" Each evening on the news, people were interviewed by reporters all over the world. Members of the public, often couples and families. COVID patients' husbands and wives were questioned and comforted. None of them were same-sex couples. Of the families tragically separated, none of them were same-sex parents. COVID-19 does not discriminate, but aspects of the media still do. We need pride. During the Black Lives Matter demonstration, the world is finally starting to wake up to the innate racism that ashamedly exists in our communities. There were a couple of black reporters, but it revealed to me how few there are outside these reports. We need Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter is a global cry for the world to acknowledge the struggles that far too many people go through because of inequality. So too is pride. Because it can be difficult to relate to the world when you cannot relate to how the world's stories are told. At times, it feels exclusive, because it is. There is a response where the church can take the lead. Because at the heart of God's message lies the truth that we are wonderful and wonderfully made. God, our Creator, certainly does not discriminate, but loves us all, both individually and equally. From the psalm today, "I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, and my soul knows very well." When I was growing up as a teenager, grappling with the fact that I was different and at times ashamed to be gay, this psalm helped teach me that I wasn't a faggot in God's eyes or a second-class citizen in the city of God. I was Simon, wonderfully made, created in God's image. My soul came to know it very well. And this is our message to everyone who, because of their gender, sexuality, or color of skin, feels that they do not belong in God's sacred creation. You are wonderful. And that is why absolutely everyone should be proud. Even though the Paris Pride March will take place in November, June is Pride Month. The Black Lives Matter movement has dominated the news this month, yet you don't see members of the LGBTQIA+ community posting phrases such as "Gay Lives Matter too," firstly, because it's outrageous, but secondly, and more importantly, because as a community, we know the importance of standing side by side and supporting one another. Racism means that we need Black Lives Matter, and homophobia and transphobia mean that we need pride. There is no prejudice in God. We are proud to belong to God's sacred family as citizens of God's kingdom. The news on television or social media may tell you that you don't fit in, but God doesn't. God tells us to be strong and proud. From Ecclesiasticus, "Watch for the opportune time and beware of evil, and do not be ashamed to be yourself. Do not show partiality to your own harm or deference to your downfall. Do not refrain from speaking at the proper moment, and do not hide your wisdom. Fight to the death for truth, and the Lord God will fight for you." I believe that God is proud of their creation. I believe that God will be with each and every one of us as we fight for truth, whatever gender, sexuality, or color of skin. And if God is with us, who can be against us? When we are finally allowed back into church and to receive Holy Communion, Jesus and the Episcopal Church tell us that the bread of heaven and the cup of salvation are offered to everyone, regardless of their gender, sexuality, or color of skin. Jesus said, "Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink." In Christ's truth, there is no discrimination. The Lord's table is the only table in this world that revives the soul of everyone who comes to it, with tired, open hands and mouths thirsty for salvation. If God does not discriminate, why should we? And that is why we need pride, to show the world that we are willing to fight for truth. For the truth that lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, asexual, or however one finds the courage to identify with oneself, black or white, all belong and all are welcome. We are all an integral part of God's world. God knows it. The psalmists knew it. I came to know it. Imagine what a world would be like if everyone knew that they were wonderfully made by a loving creator. There will, of course, be times in the face of adversity that you don't know it or find it hard to fight for truth and be proud, when shame rears its ugly head and threatens pride. Remember that you are wonderful and wonderfully made by a loving God. During the hard times, pray and welcome God in. Listen to God. Seek God in your friends in Christ. Pray daily, because we cannot do it by ourselves, and God understands that. Selective reporting is just one of the many sins that gets in the way of God's inclusive truth. Marginalization and exclusion, threatening equal love and inclusion. So that is why we still need pride. That is why we need Black Lives Matter movement. That is why we need Christ, to replace exclusion from love with God's inclusive love. Easier said than done when you stand in the face of prejudice. But when the task seems too hard, and when you realize afresh that you're not in control of things, take a deep breath and remember who is. The God you know. The Christ of love. The Spirit of healing. God's truth will help us all in our fight for truth. You're in safe hands. Alleluia. Amen.
God of love, we thank you for the spirits who were trailblazers, moving and shaking people's hearts and minds. Stir up in us that same energy of those who helped pave the way for where our LGBTQIA+ siblings are today. May we never stop expanding the borders of love and acceptance for queer, brown, and black bodies. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Compassionate Jesus, on the days when this work of justice and reconciliation feels like too much, help lighten our load, soften our hearts to welcome people of all sexual orientations, gender identities, and gender expressions, in all of the bodies in which they encompass. Teach us to learn and relearn with humanity and excitement. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Creator God, we marvel in awe of the expansiveness of your creation, Your margins of diversity are boundless, and for that we thank you. Each of our beloved LGBTQIA+, brown, and black siblings are beautifully and wonderfully made, all in your image. Teach us to love people just as they are and embrace their identity fully as you have embraced us. In your mercy, hear our prayer.
Great Creator, who makes and models in divine and marvelous way. You gave us life and love and laughter and companion on the way. You give us grace to love each another as you have loved us, and in the sight to see you as our eternal source, for you live and reign with the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. In your mercy, hear our prayer.
Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My sisters and brothers, the peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
We'd like to thank everyone who made this
video possible and for all those involved in its production. And we invite you to a potluck picnic following this service. We will meet on the Seine at Esplanade Habib Bourguiba at 6 o'clock. If you'd like to meet at the cathedral around 5:45, we'll be leaving and heading over there. We hope that you can join us.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and His Son, Jesus Christ, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you and all you love and care for, now and always.
Amen.
Let us go forth in the world, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.